Well, I had struggled with my weight from ages 18 to 50, and it was 32 years of every diet in the world, every exercise program. I even went to rehab for food addiction, a 28-day program in the desert, and it was freaking horrible. Nothing worked. I decided I wasn't a failure. The diets had been a failure. I was trying to diet my way into something that 90% of people fail at diets. So I just said, you know what? I want to try to save my life here. I don't want to get to 70 years old, be 400 pounds, and die too young. This is a no-brainer. Live longer. I feel what I've gained with the surgery is a real understanding of why I overate and why I'm still compelled to overeat. So basically, if I can't stuff feelings with food because now it's physically impossible to, why am I compelled to eat? Meaning, okay, what's the real issue down there? What's the hole I'm trying to fill? So I've gained an understanding, or at least, you know, started to gain an understanding of what's really going on with me. What are my real issues? So, you know, I'm in therapy. I go to retreats about emotional eating. You know, I just am gaining like what's really inside me versus thinking it's food, because it's really not food. That's just your substance of abuse. I am sick of the stigma of, oh, you're weak, so you got the surgery. If they knew the list of things that you have to go through, I mean, the foaming at the mouth, the taking a sip every 3 minutes so that you get dehydrated or you have to go to the hospital. Then you're trying to go number two to the bathroom, you have to push so hard, it's like you're a Prius. I mean, the stuff is not easy. So people think, oh, it's cheating, it's the easy way out. And I wanted to show them, it ain't easy. Yes, the pounds come off more easily, but it's not easy. So I felt compelled as somebody who's in the public to go, I'm not ashamed, and I'm never gonna not talk about it. But me, I've always been honest in my comedy, so I said it can't stop now. And I just think it's fantastic when people actually say, you know what, I'm doing this for me and I have no apologies. You're a little c**t. No, I don't really even know why I said that, but there was no c**t thrown out there tonight, so I felt it had to happen. No, to the camera. You've tried everything and you have a clear conscience that you can't do this any other way, get yourself a consultation with a good surgeon, because guess what? You want to live? Get her done.